Oh, oh.
Please remain standing. And next, play the national anthem, Sergeant Steph Matthew Hart. Pretty sure we're not going to need you. It's going to be the most glorious event ever, because we're going to have a safe event. But I want to recognize a few people. Captain Jim Choi, he wants to say a few words.
Hey, thank you, everyone. On behalf of Chief Fawn S. Snow, I'd like to welcome everyone to this awesome event, all the wonderful athletes here, and also in our audience here, Mayor Larry Klein, City of Sunnyvale. Thank you for being here. I'm gonna head over back to the here, but I just want everyone to have a safe event, have fun, and once again, just thank everyone for your support. Dory Fontaine, where she at? Once again, the president of the Sunnyvale Police Activities Club. Not just the boxing match, but everything else, all these community events that the DPS puts on, that the police activity puts on, Dory Fontaine. So one more round of applause, please. Lieutenant Jose Ramirez, who's been a big integral part of boxing here in Sunnyvale, with all the youth and all the colleges, so thank you very much.
Thank you. And next, Gary, you want to say a few words?
No one will be able to see me. Anyway, I just want to say, obviously, a quick thank you to Dory as well. She does a ton to put this thing on. All the coaches got this place, tip-top shape, and helped our boxers get ready for the event as well. Saturday, I want to point out Joe Fierce. He started this all at Sunnyvale. Yeah. So thanks for coming back, Joe. Good to see you. And really, really want to thank all the boxers. You guys, many of you guys traveled from all corners of the West Coast to get here from Colorado, Washington, Road Warriors, and Brandon and Andy. Man, sat in 5 hours of snow before they opened it again. They were just a half hour early. Anyway, Southern California, UCLA, and everybody's at UC Davis, Berkeley, everybody's traveling from all over to put on a great show for you guys today. And so I want to thank you guys. You guys really make it happen. And lastly, too, the officials. It was a tight day today. They have two events going on, but they made it happen. and they are the reason why we're able to put these events on, and their support, and Dr. Buff-Grader as well, has been doing this forever, and that's one of the hardest things to find is Dr. to help work the events. And he's a huge fan, so we're extremely lucky, so thank you very much. So, you know, this event has been going on initially for many 6 years here, and we had it in Santa Clara for quite a while as well. But it's always to honor one of our alumni boxers, Dodge Ackerman, fantastic person, amazing boxer. And to tell you his story, we're going to have his coach, Coach Candy, as well, followed by his sister, Kobe Ackerman. He's flown all the way from Hawaii, where Dodge was from, so you might see a little Hawaiian flair today. Okay, so Candy.
Good afternoon, everyone. It was an honor and a privilege for my participation in coaching Dodge, knowing him, and comparting some of the things that he did. A little bit about him. Fall 1998, this tall, lanky, curly-haired young man entered our plural out there, young man. So what happened is that Dodge was defending one of his fellow classmates against a bully. He got much larger, and of course Dodge was able to take care of business. Unfortunately, he broke his hand. January 2002, during the team's training runs, I noticed that Dodge was limping and not keeping up his first place in all the runs. Questioned me a little bit. He said, "Don, I got a little soreness in my hip. Why don't we get it checked out before the season gets too far underway? Go see a doctor." Dodge, sir, because it was the honorable thing to do, he embodied the warrior spirit. During his medical treatment, Dodge stayed positive and refused to be bitter. His physician, Dr. Chen, stated it was never about death at Dodge. It was always about living life to his fullest. On June 21st, 2003, Dodge lost his life to cancer. I believe that Dodge is still with us in spirit, and his heart will always be in this boxing ring. Rest in peace, Dodge. Thank you.
Being here and being a part of this and helping keep my brother's spirit alive, it means so much to all of our friends and family back home on the Big Island. And I'll just tell you a little bit about my brother, since I know most of you never met him. But when we were little kids, my dad used to take us down to this old airport, basically an abandoned old airport, and my dad would run this runway back and forth. And when my brother and I were little, I think my brother was probably about 8 years old, we heard this commotion going on in this kind of abandoned little building. My brother ran over, and sure enough, there were these big Hawaiians and Samoans boxing. I mean, couldn't tear my brother away from me, he just wanted to watch. And when my dad was done running, he said, "Dad, come here, I want to show you something." So he brought my dad over, and my dad's watching. My brother's saying, this is what I want to do, I want to do this. And my dad's looking at his little 8-year-old. I'm like, "Why do you want to do this?" And I said, "Well, this is what you want to do, go talk to him." So this skinny little...
Thank you.
I want to introduce the Sunnyvale Department of Public Safety Chaplain, Jim Aslan. Would you like to say a few words of blessing?
Would you pray with me? Lord, we're thankful to be here. Thank you for life and breath. Thank you for young athletes with a competitive spirit, for strong bodies, strong minds, strong wills in a lot of cases. And I pray that you would produce in this environment, this competition, this tournament today, not so much an opportunity to defeat an opponent, but an opportunity to simply do their best, each and every one of them. I thank you, Father, for the parents, the friends, the family who have come to support these young men and women who are boxing today. I want to say a special thank you for the coaches who have invested countless hours, sacrificial hours, investing themselves into these these young athletes who maybe one day not long ago were in the limelight in the ring, but now they've decided to divest themselves in the investment of young athletes. So with all of these things, we ask that you would superintend this today, and whether rain or shine, I pray you'd help everybody to keep their gloves up. Amen.
Thanks very much. One thing I also wanted to mention, and that we try to make part of this event every year, is to do something that would make a difference, something that Dodge would be proud of as well. And Santa Clara Boxing always tries to help out Be the Match every year, and they have a table set up right behind us over there. Say hi, Emily. And Be the Match, if you don't know, they do a bone marrow registry, and it's really the last ditch effort for everybody who has gone through all the treatments to try to find a bone marrow match. And just simply by signing up, they'll send you a Q-tip to swab your cheek. There's a probably chance of 1 in 400 that you ever be picked. But if you are that person, you're the one person on this earth that could, you know, save someone's life. So it's just a quick story of why I actually found Be the Match. Because I was a coworker, and she went to go visit a friend who was terminally ill. And she would bring her M&Ms, because that's what she liked. And she asked her, you know, what can I do for you? I said, what can you do for somebody who's literally got weeks to live? She's very positive, and she said, just sign up for Be the Match. Because 2 years ago, she found a match. She was cancer-free for 2 years, and had small children, and just absolutely enjoyed being cancer-free with them for 2 years. It was the best gift she ever got. And so that's what she would ask people. What to do for her. So it's very simple. It's a chance to be a hero. Very slim chance, but especially you boxers, you guys are preoccupied right now. This is not mandatory for anybody, but to give it some thought, to go talk to the people over there. The Santa Clara Box team is really enjoying supporting them, and be a feel-good thing to the one or you. So again, thank you very much. Jose, we'll turn it over to you for the last words.
Thank you, everyone. Who's ready to see some fights? Let's get it on. Please remain standing for the retirement of the colors. Bagpipers. For the boxers, you're going to be exiting the same corner. You guys can go ahead and start exiting too. Ready?
boys. Don't let him for it. Come on. He's coming to us. Oh, fine.
Yes, sir.
Go, go, go.
Go, go. Go,
go.
Body there.
Go, go, go.
Huskies!
Let's go, Chris!
Yeah.
Last one, I mean, here we go.
Yeah, Kristen.
Stay up.
Go ahead. There you go. Keep going. Go. Get out of it, Raiders. Stay on it. Keep going. Back to the roof. Keep going.
You're fresh, man.
Keep going. Back to the jab.
Pressure.
Harry, double jab.
Shoot it again.
Jab.
See that
one,
right? 1-2.
1-2. Back to the head.
Good body
shot. Move your head. Roll.
Good.
Hands up.
That's your pressure.
Jab.
Every round.
Hands up, Irene. You gotta roll. Keep
going, Matty.
Back to the jab.
Looking close.
Don't reach. 1-1-2. 1-1-2.
Again,
yeah.
Set.
1-1-2, go!
Finish, man, come on! Yeah,
stop!
Come on, keep going! 1, good job! 2,
yes.
3, okay. 4, 5, 6, 7,
go,
8,
go, go, 5,
go, 5, go, 5,
go, 5, go, 5,
go,
5, go, 5, go, 5, go,
5,
go, 5,
go,
5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5,
go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go,
5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go, 5, go,
Yes,
I
get it!
Keep going,
man!
Keep going, Irene!
Hands up!
Push, man,
push!
Hands up, forward!
Come forward!
Back to the jab!
Left!
Come forward now!
Under control, hands.